Okay, what is off-page SEO is primarily off-page, in off-page SEO, we try to do link building. Okay, now before doing link building, we should know a lot of things. So I'm giving you first the theoretical part and then the practical part we will do. So the background or the background history of off-page SEO starts with PageRank. When Google came into existence in 1998 or 1996, what happened is Google was Yahoo was the search engine before that. There was no other search engine before that. Yahoo was it. And what Yahoo used to do is Yahoo used to rank the website, but you have to pay for it, like $200 a month. If you pay, your website will rank simply. So what Google does is Google said, and Yahoo was very, very popular. It was like Google is very popular nowadays. Market share is 70 or 75%. At that time, Yahoo was like 98-99%. Okay. So nobody messes with Yahoo in that. So what Google does, Google said, my listings are free. Okay. So there were other smaller search engine as well at that time, but they were asking $10, some were asking $5. Google said, my search engine is free. Everyone can come and list, start listing the website. So what happened, like what you see Just Dive is the version of Google at that time or the version of Yahoo at that time. Okay, after that, what happened is then people start listing it and people like me, who are a little, who work out of the way, they start misusing it. Okay. Then what used to happen is, then they have start building the algorithm. The first algorithm is that keyword should be there in the page so that they can match it. Okay. Then we, people like us, cracked it and we know where to put those keywords, and then we start ranking. Like we make a website today and we submit it to Google next day and we start ranking. This continues till 2003 and 4, even I can say till 2007. Okay, it continued. But Google was developing multiple algorithms and Google was expanding itself. And we were actually trying to do spamming primarily, and we were ranking on top always. And the main website who used to do a business were asking for leads or sales from us, not from Google, because they were not ranking on Google. So it slowly continues. After a point of time, what happened is Google developed a lot of algorithms which were not just focused about keywords. They built a parameter called PageRank. Okay. It was named after the founder of Google, that is Larry Page. Okay, this algorithm or this ranking factor came into existence, that is PageRank. And Google used to determine the importance of the web page. Okay, and used to give rating between 0 to 10, 10 being the highest. And they have a lot of factors in it, but they never revealed the factor. What is the exact factor on which they are rating? That's why it is a secret with them. So people like us got stuck with it, and then we were like, how to improve the page rank, because higher the page rank, chances are better. But page rank is not the only factor to rank on Google. So Google have been very secretive about it. And through these algorithms, what they are trying to do is they are trying to give best value to their users. How to give best value to their user is by giving relevant results. So they start judging web pages on not only one factor, more than 200 factors. Okay, but they develop one algorithm or one factor which is very prominent, that was PageRank. But now Google has discarded PageRank in around 2013. Okay, so it is considered as a dead. So what used to happen is in PageRank, if you are ranking high on PageRank, your chances, whatever different keywords you have used on your website, you will rank. But to get a PageRank is also not that easy, but there are a lot of ways to get it. The earlier lot of ways were the page or the website which has high PageRank. If you get a link from them, your PageRank will improve. Like I get 10,000 links from a PageRank of 8, then my PageRank would be around 7 to 8 in within 3 months and all. Okay, so this is also start happening, and then Google thought about it and then start improving their algorithms, and they discarded that PageRank factor. They can't work it anymore. So after that, in 2013, they discarded this algorithm and they have not used it. So after that, they come with different 8 to 9 algorithms which are existing, which are updating, like core update is there, EMD update is there, then hummingbird update is there, or algorithm, then penguin algorithm is there. There are multiple algorithms which are running. But the core crux of every algorithm or every method which Google is using is somewhere near to what they were doing in the past. But yes, it has added a lot of filter layers to it. Like you earlier, fooling Google was very, very easy. Like when I used to do it in 2010, when I was in college, I still rank any website on any keyword in max 28 days. Max to max, like 28 days was the last time I used to rank them. In India especially, it's like 7 days, 6 days, 5 days. Okay. That time in 2009 and 10, it was that easy because the factor was very clear. I know how to get those 8,000 links. I have tied up with all the links and I just drop them an email and send to them that I will pay you $1 for each, and $8,000 were paid. At that time, the dollar prices were around 44, 45. No, it was 55 something. 45 to 55 something, I can't remember it exactly. And we used to pay, and in minutes, in next week, we used to rank. And then there are a lot of website owners who have a lot of websites, then we start doing joint dealings and all. Google got to know, and then Google start analyzing these websites as well. But this continues. Okay, but still their factors are similar, but it's just one thing that has improved is number of filters. Okay, like age of your domain is fine, but Google will check how much time it was active, how many users, how many owners has been changed, what is their system. Okay, so these all things Google have start checking now. Earlier it was like if I buy a domain 20 years old, like somebody bought in 1990s when the trend started, then I rank it like if a 10 years old domain in 2010, somebody bought in 2000, I start ranking it. But now they have added factors like if that domain was active for throughout this life, or they have some traffic on it or not, what kind of content earlier it was there, now what kind of content it is there. So they keep adding a layer. This layer they have added. Okay, number of backlinks. Earlier just number of backlinks, quality of backlinks, link juice. Okay, these factors. Okay, quality of the content, domain authority, and page authority. These were the factors on which PageRank used to calculate all the things. But now we don't have to dig into it much more. Reason being, this is not in use, like last 5 years, this has not been in use. So it's of no use, but the factors remain the same. Okay, now what happens is a couple of concepts I will explain you, and I will explain few of more terminologies, so that you can understand it. Till this point, is it clear to you the history of Google, how it developed and everything? and PageRank. Is that clear to you? Okay, Chaitanya says it's clear, Aditya says it's clear, Ranjana. Okay. Sudhanshu. Okay. Now there is a concept called link juice. This is critically very important to understand. What is link juice? Link juice is the share of page rank that is transferred to the web page via link. The concept which I have explained you earlier, like if I start taking link from a website which has a page rank 8 and my page rank is 0, if I start taking links from it, then my page rank will improve. Okay. So primarily what when somebody gives me a link is primarily transferring a link juice to me. Okay. When somebody is giving a link to me, means they are giving a link juice. Means they have some power, they have transferred some power to me so that my powers are improving. Okay. That is link juice. If you want to read in detail, I have given you a couple of articles to read about the history as well, if you wish it. Okay. Then next is the important factor is domain authority, which is used now also. Okay, domain authority depends on page rank, backlink, quality and quantity. Third is traffic and fourth is age of the domain. Okay, so domain authority depends on page rank, means content, domain. Okay, traffic and age of the domain. Earlier, traffic was not considered as a factor. Now it is considered as a factor. And it is relevant. Domain authority is calculated on these factors that people know. Okay, apart from that, there are other factors on which domain authority is calculated, which is still unknown to people. And who calculates domain authority? Moz is the tool through which you can check the domain authority. Okay, page rank, so is not a valid term, page authority. Okay, now you can check domain authority and page authority of any particular page or any particular website through that tool. Let me take questions one by one. Before that, I was saying domain authority is also known as DA. And it is calculated again between 0 to 100, where 100 is the highest. The more domain authority you have, the more chances of your website to rank are higher. Okay, Ranjana has a question. So giving links to other website which is ranking high is a good method to improve your page ranking? No. Taking backlinks, taking links from those sites which are ranking to our website is a good method. Okay, you are just saying the reverse. Aditya says, please convert the SEO final document into a Google Doc and give a few rights. Sure, this is a live document actually. I keep on improving it as per each training. And so it is already shared. I will reshare it with you by converting today it into a Google Doc and share it with everyone. Okay, next, everyone should go and install this Moz bar. Okay, you can say Moz toolbar or Moz bar. How to do it is go on Moz or go on Google, type Moz bar. That's it. It will show the product site and then click on download Moz bar. And you can use it over only desktop. You can't use it over your mobile phone. So you can't check it over mobile phone, but you can use this toolbar only on the desktop version of your Google Chrome or even on your other browser like Mozilla Firefox. but beyond that you can't. Okay, everyone just go and download it and install it. After that, once you install it, if you go on Google, let's say I typed searching content writing course. Okay. And then click on this small bar. Then it will ask you to log in or create account. For you, you have to create create an account. I already have, and it's a free account. You can create it. Okay. Now just refresh it. Okay. If you go down in organic results, you can see the page authority and domain authority. Okay. So all you can see of any website. Okay. Of any website, you can see the page authority and domain authority of that particular page, which is ranking. So you go and install that. Okay. After that, do you guys have any question? Is that clear to everyone? And everyone just go and install MozBar also right now, because most of the times you forgot doing it. So go ahead and install the MozBar and create an account quickly. Once you have installed and create the account with MozBar, just press 1 into the chat box quickly, guys.